Everything Chris. Everything Chris. Everything Chris. Everything, everything. Everything Chris. Everything Chris. Everything Chris. Everything, everything Chris.
Again, got one more this evening. Gonna wait. Hey, all right. For more people to join in on us.
Let me see if this can turn to the side, man.
Yo.
Yeah. What I'm not.
What I'm rushing on. We just get back from the gym, you know. Hey, I'm good, bro.
See, I'm the yaki and fish. And then when they start fish, man, they don't think that.
No, I mean, I cook the dog.
That's super nice. Just get the flour and dash it in the pot.
Yeah, trust me. What's good, though?
I'm good, bro. How you been, man?
Not much, man. Just trying to deal with this stupid quarantine life.
Yeah.
I've been here for like, what, 3 weeks now? Sorry, one second. Just try to get my phone and talk at the same time.
Just
trying to manage it, man. You know what I'm saying? Just trying to manage it. Been on Facebook Marketplace. I bought some stuff for the house.
Okay, nice.
Using the house and that. But
so when you residing in London or Manchester still?
No, I'm in London now, man. In South London, man. South.
Oh, you're a South man as well?
No, I'm a North man, but I moved to South now, man. I'm a South man now.
Whereabouts in South?
Like near Crystal Palace.
Oh, yeah.
Crystal Palace.
One of the meccas of basketball.
Yeah.
All right, man. So how's the quarantine? How you been dealing with the quarantine anyway?
To be fair, you know, it's like, I'm not really that fussed about it, because obviously I've got everything here now. So I've got my treadmill, I've got the little weights. Okay. You know what I mean? So like, I've just been trying to manage myself. You know, this quarantine life, if you don't take stuff serious, you're just going to start putting on weight. You know what I mean? So, but apart from that, it's just a socializing aspect. It's not really like just staying inside or...
That's true, you know. It's
the socializing aspect and just like getting to the, you know, now like the season's coming towards the end. So, you know, now everyone's in the off season now. So everyone's seeing each other. Everyone's going up and down. Do you know what I mean? Like, so it's just that aspect of part of it. But apart from that, it's not really troubled me that much. If you know what I mean? Because like most of my family's in Jamaica. So like in Jamaica and that, it's not really affecting them over there. So I can't really say, like our families and that, I understand where they're coming from, but from my point of view, like my family and that, they're chilling in Jamaica, do you know what I'm saying? So, they're not really, do you know what I mean? They're not really affected by what's going on right now.
Mm-hmm. I hear that. Same with myself, really. It's like, I do a lot of, I'm a key worker, so really, I'm not really always in the house.
Well, you're a key worker. Work.
Yeah. So working the trains, so like I go to work and then you know it's quiet at work anyway. So not even no one's hardly traveling unless they're key workers. There's no one traveling.
That
occupied me. And on top of it, I'm occupied by this stuff I'm doing now, where I'm just focusing on trying to think of ways to get it out there, and get more. Working the brand a lot more.
I like the logo though. The way you came out of it though. Everything, Chris. That's sick.
Thanks, man.
You need to start like doing like more content and like just your like a content creator. I don't know if you can like make videos and all that sort of graphics and all that sort of stuff, but I think if you get that, you can take that to the next level, man.
I like that. I take that on board, definitely, man. Just do some more videos and stuff. So yeah, that's what my plan is. Be more. I've got a show. I'm basically doing a show, and that's coming out soon. So. that'll be airing
podcast
soon.
Or
there's gonna be a show, a talk show. So like I know a lot of people do podcasts, but I'm more focused on the visuals. I want people to
see. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah, the visuals is the thing that gets. Yeah,
and I want to have more because I'm a person. I'm more of a fun, interacting person. Anyway, I want people to see that side of myself and the person now that I interact with them. So
I think it can work because you see, like what Thing's doing for Hooper's Voice. You see how that's getting big.
That's
and he's getting his stuff. He's getting his stuff going, man. It's like I said. It's just like building your brand. Like even how I keep messaging him. Like he's probably watching now. I keep asking about about the t-shirts and. T-shirts, the hoodies, and all that sort of stuff because he's fun. He's funny on Instagram and on Twitter and stuff. So like, he needs to start making like the famous lost guy. Like he needs to start making like branding. Like I keep messaging him. Like, I want t-shirts. I want hoodies. I wear your stuff. Like, do you know what I mean? Like, it's just about supporting each other. Like, especially like with England basketball and everything like
Definitely,
that. More people support each other, the more it will get bigger. Do you know what I mean? It's just like Pro Classic and stuff over the years. Look how big Pro Classic's got.
And this is the thing I've been talking about all day because with people, like, the support needs to be pushed out there, man. Like, we all need that support. Shout out Hooper's Voice, the scene in there. But yeah, we all need that support, man. And that we need to just keep pushing each other, like, you know what I mean? I see that.
I just think there's too many, like, it's a lot of. It's not like it's like negativity. Like, it is, like, positive criticism, but, like, I think there's just a lot of like negative light shined on English basketball. Do you know what I mean? Like, it's just like, it needs to be a bit more positive, man. Do you know what
Definitely,
I mean?
Definitely, man.
Like,
definitely,
individuals, man. Players, organizations, I just think like more, it needs to be more positive. Like, there should be more positive. You push, like, I like what Steve Veer does on Twitter and Instagram. Like, he's like one of the realest ones out there. Like, do you know what I mean? Like, we need to put people like him in power. Do you know what I mean? Like, power of other things. Like, the sort of thing about Pops, like, he didn't get the job for England basketball. I was like, what? How can he not get the job? Like, we need those type of guys because those are the generation just before us. So they know.
They were, yeah.
They know what needs to be put in place because they're from that generation, but also they can relate to our generation because they're still in our generation.
And I've mentioned this before as well. Yeah. And I mentioned before as well. It was good that Justin won MVP twice because, yo, that was such an amazing thing because it's like.
Yeah, because the English player.
Some
player wins MVP.
Exactly, and some players who win MVP, they like to think they're the dog's bollocks, or they just act like, you know, they want to pretend they're something they're not. Justin from, he's a man,
just goes by his business.
Just I'm saying, silent. And he's a man them as well, so you can approach him and say, yo, what's good, man? That two-time MVP, someone like Justin, you could say to him, hey, let's go down to the Caribbean shop and get some jerk chicken and dumpling. Justin's that kind of person.
Yeah, that's an MVP, he's down to earth and he's silent, man.
And that's where some other.
It's all business, boy.
Yeah, exactly.
On the court, though.
He's going to kill him on the court.
He's trying to win, boy. Justin wants to do is win on the court. He's a different player, bro.
Off the court, he's one person as well. And you know what I'm saying? Some MVPs, they win MVP. They think, yeah, I'm a Flamie Young now, man. I want to eat my Flamie Young and steak and be like,
yeah, I want everything.
That.
Yeah, I'm there. Yeah.
No, Justin just says, look, boom, he's straight up. I'm saving money, bro. Like, he's a type of person. If you had a choice between steak and going Morley's, bro, we'd be in Morley's in that.
Morley's all day.
The two piece and chips and two wings in that, we just sit there eating. That's Justin, bro. And I love that. That's one of you.
Yeah.
Too many steakheads, man. That, you know what I mean, bro? Yeah, as I was saying, we need to support each other a bit more, man. Pro Classic, I don't know what's going on with that at the moment.
It's got to be this year, man. It has to be.
You know what? My brother was saying is the reason they do it because it's like for people, just it's a platform for people to come and, you know what I mean, off season. Usually, because back in the day, we used to have so much stuff like Rough and Ready, if you remember, Rough and Ready.
Yeah. And then they had that run and gun in Kent as well, something like that.
Yeah, and you had a flipping Pro-Am, Hosanna, you had so many things.
Yeah. What?
It's like disappearing. I don't know, man. They just started disappearing. So that's what Pro Classic did. They said, you know, we need to fill that void up because it's not about anymore, man.
Yeah.
And obviously, I've met a lot of people through Pro Classic, like yourself. I met Hooper's Voice. I met. That's when I discovered Ryan Martin. And he was a beast, and that, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
That was a big thing, Pro Classic, man. But you, your still journey, you went to junior college, or was it?
Yeah, so like, I don't know, like, it's just a weird thing, like, I didn't start playing, but, like, when I was in school and stuff, obviously I was from North and stuff, so, like, North London, you don't really have all much hoopers in London, in North London, you know, we do, you know what I'm saying, like, you've got, like, Drew Sullivan, and you got, like, Orland, but then, obviously, Orland, all them guys, they went to Hackney, so they didn't really, they always went North, but they that environment, do you know what I mean, so, like, me coming up at North London, like, I went to Southgate College. So, I went to Southgate College, and, like, when I was in secondary school, I used to play basketball. I never used to take basketball serious. Do you know what I mean? Like, I never used to take it serious. Like, do you know what I mean? So, like, when I got to college, like, after school, some of my friends would keep playing, but then I didn't really play when I was in second college. It's only until, like, the second year of college where I started taking it serious, because I've always been a big guy, innit? So, then I lost, like, a ton of weight. So I was thinking, like, do you know what, yeah, let me just keep playing basketball. So I started playing, this is when I was about 18, when I started taking it serious. You know what I mean? So I started playing, I played at Southgate for a year. So I played at Southgate, I played at Division 2, then I was playing local league for London Metropolitan League in, I can't remember where it is it in Henley?
Yeah, I remember London Metropolitan.
Yeah, so I was playing there, but because I was at college, my college was affiliated with Middlesex University. So the course I was doing at Southgate was like an access course to go to university, so I could play for the university and play at the college at the same time. So obviously I was playing for Middlesex, then I was playing D2, then I was playing locally for London Metney, so I just kept taking it serious now. Then I met, do you know Matt Baptiste?
The name sounds familiar, if I see his face.
He ran the UK Elite Adidas thing, and Andrea used to work with him as well. Do you remember Adidas thing? So then I started going there, and that's when I started, like, picking up playing basketball properly. So I went there, and then they had, like, a showcase thing, like, and everyone was just telling me, like, you know how UK is, like, everyone's like, oh, yeah, there's going to be these American scouts, the American coaches coming over to watch.
There's all this
sort of stuff like that, and I was just thinking, nah, I'm not going to this, man. This is some joke thing. Like, do you know what I mean? Like, that's how I am. Yeah. Isn't it? You know what I'm saying? Like, that's how a lot of young guys are. Like, they're just like, oh, forget this, man. I'm not going, man. This is just a joke, man. Why am I going here? So I was like, anyways. So people was like, yeah, just go, man. It's just a scrimmage. So I went there. There was quite a few people there. Cavrell was there. There was quite a few people there. So like, that's what you think, yeah, it's all right. So it was a little scrimmage thing. So there was like four coaches there, and like we was just playing. So then at the end of the scrimmage, now one of them, which was like my assistant coach, he must have took me outside. He's like, yeah, he's like, I've got a scholarship for you. I was like, rah.
Like that.
So I was just like, he's like, yeah, I've got a scholarship for you, but it wasn't like a full ride thing. It wasn't a full ride, but it was basically 75%, so I had to pay like 25%. But obviously, I'm in college, innit? So I'm thinking to myself, like, yo, like, I've got to take this because I haven't got anything else. Do you know what I mean? Like, I haven't got anything else.
Yeah.
So I was like, I came home, told my mom. The mom was like, yeah, you should just go in it. So I was like, you know what? Yeah, I just have to try and find this. I'm gonna have to find this $2,000 somewhere to get myself over there. I've done what I had to do. Then I went to Iowa. It was a cool school called Iowa Central. So I went there. I went there for a year, and that was like an eye opener because when I went to the States, like I've never, like growing up, I never got to play with all of those guys. I didn't come up with them lot. Do you know what I mean? I didn't come up with none of those guys from my. Well, my age range, like all of them are, I think, like 1 or 2 years older than me. But I never came up with none of those guys. So I never used to play around like elite hoopers like all the time. So it's just like when I went to the Duke Hall now, it was just like the first, I'm not even going to lie to you, the first week of preseason, that's when it tested me. Like, there's one day, I got to my thing, I was like, am I actually ready for that to play fucking. Sorry, my language, like professional, like not professional basketball, I'm really ready to take this basketball thing serious. Like, cause like the preseason, the first week, bro, the warm up, was a mile in under. You had to run it in 5 minutes. Like you had to run it in under 5 minutes. So you can
under 5 minutes.
You got to a 4:59 to run a mile. That was a warm up.
That's the warm up, yo. You got to run a mile.
Warm up. So like, if you didn't make it, you're going again. So like, the first week was tough. But then like, that's when it was like the first week, and then I was like, I mentally brought down. I was thinking to myself like, do I really want to be here? And obviously it was the isolation thing, because I'm there by myself, and like obviously I haven't got no friends or anything like that. So I'm thinking to myself, like, remember back then it was like BlackBerry, everyone had that BlackBerry. Everyone is on BlackBerry then. Remember?
Yeah, ping, ping.
So everyone's doing their thing back home, and I'm just sitting there in my room, like, just dead, thinking like with my own thoughts. So I was thinking to myself, after the first couple of weeks came by, I got through it. So then it's just like, I was just like, yeah. Like, this is what I came here for, innit? Because that's when I got, like, my body. That's when my body really got in shape. Do you know what I mean? And then, like, I just from there on, it just went from strength to strength. And then there was these two English guys that played football there. They had that football scholarships, the English football scholarships there.
You can imagine.
Like, yeah, they're, like, two of my good friends now. So, like, I met them two guys, and it was just, like, even better, because it's like, all right, cool. I've got two English guys that I can banter with, do you know what I mean? That
I've
you know what I mean? Like, so like, I could banter with them. So it made the transition even more easier. And then my coach was like, "Do you want to live with them guys?" So you spoke to the soccer coach, and I lived with them lot. Do you know what I mean?
Well, like, made sense then.
So like, that made it even better. So yeah, I went to Duco. Then I supposed to go to a D2 school in Manhattan. I supposed to go to Manhattan College.
Yeah,
but then. So, like, in the preseason, like, we said in the States, when you play Duco, you go to, like, this thing called a Jamboree, and, like, all these schools from different places, like, go there to look at scouting people, innit? So, I've been speaking to this school from the beginning. I've gone to Duco, because I went to the first Jamboree. They sent me, like, a letter of intent that, yeah, we're interested in you, blah, 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 blah. So, when I finished Duco now, I was supposed to go to that school, but I got ruled eligible by NCAA. For what reason, I don't know. It's because I played Met League. So they were trying to contact the administration. You know how London Met League is not run properly. They couldn't contact them. Yeah,
obviously,
it was like, yeah, we don't know whether you're getting paid or whatever. So I'm sitting there thinking, nah, I can't go back to England. Like, yeah. I need to go to finish my thing, innit? So anyway, they ruled me eligible now. So then I came back. But obviously, some of the people that I met at the scrimmage that got me the scholarship in the first place, some of them went to Loughborough. So some people like Swift... Do you know Swift?
No, his name sounds familiar again, but...
Yeah, so Swift and a couple of other people were there. They was like, yeah, Dean, come down to Loughborough. If you can't get back to the States, you should come to Loughborough. But obviously, I was thinking to myself, like, no, I want to go back to the States. I want to stay here. Like, do you know what I mean? Like,
yeah,
just,
finish
you
know, it,
that
yeah.
stigma in your thing is like, yeah, I'm going back to the States. I'm not staying here. I'm not going back to England. So then he's like, I've got a rude eligible, and the thing was still going through the process. So the coach from the States was still fine my case. He's like, Dean, if you want to go study, you want to start somewhere else. He's like, yeah, we're still fine your case. That the worst case scenario is that you come in the semester afterwards in January. So I was like, all right, cool. So I went to Loughborough now. But then Loughborough was a good look because they had everyone there. They had Connor Washington there. They had Jamel Anderson there. They had Levi Noel there.
Yeah, I heard of Jamel, yeah.
So then I went there in the summer. And like, I went for like a little tryout thing. Something else. So I went to turn up to the scrimmage. There's all these elite guys. Like when I was growing up, I never got to play with these guys. These are what I'm saying, because I wasn't good enough. Do you know what I mean? Like I wasn't good enough. Like Jamel and all those guys, that's the age range I came up with. That's my age group. But I never had like, my name was never in England Basketball, like the pool of being one list or whatever, goals to get invited to any. I was never that guy.
Yeah.
So for me to turn up on the court and then get invited to do that, I was just like, rah, like, I want to court with these guys now. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I went there now, and then they was like, yeah, you can come here, you can study here, blah, 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 blah. You get like a little scholarship or whatever. So I was thinking to myself, like, rah, like, this is Leicester Riders. Like, they just come back from winning everything.
So this is a win to Leicester, yeah?
Yeah. So then I was thinking, like, rah, like, everything's there. Like, there's good hoopers there. I'm playing with England international guys. Do you know what I mean? Like, I can get better here. Even if I can't go back to the States, this is a good opportunity because they've got the best facilities in England for sports.
Yeah, like, yeah. Leicester,
they've got the best of the best. Loughborough University has the best. So I was thinking to myself, yeah, I can come here.
So I started there now.
Started going now, and then playing everything like that. So I finished. Then it got to like January. Then they like ruled me like fully eligible. So I was thinking to myself, "I ain't cool. I'm already at Loughborough. So I might as well just finish my degree here." So I finished my foundation degree at Loughborough.
Yeah.
And then after Loughborough, I finished at Loughborough.
Everything Chris. Everything Chris. Everything Chris.